There's this unwritten rule, which is kind of silly. You're not supposed to touch the cup or lift the cup until you win the cup. So nobody knew how heavy the cup was or what it felt like. So we didn't really have any idea until I actually lifted the cup.
He's got to be feeling on top of the world now.
I thought, my God, this thing is so heavy. So there's this whole thing about who did you pass the cup to? I'm like, pass the cup to? It just kind of fell out of my hands. Whoever was standing there got it. I think Mess got it. But it wasn't a question of passing. It was a question I couldn't hold it anymore.
Any player in today's game that can step up and just win the cup in his first year, he doesn't realize how lucky he is. You've got to lose before you can win and learn those lessons along the way.
The Stanley Cup isn't really a cup. It's a bowl, a cereal bowl, a baby bowl, a horse feed bowl, a champagne bowl, and a detachable crown of boyish glory. It has been drop-kicked into an Ottawa canal, abandoned at the side of the road, and bashed, battered, and beloved for more than 100 years. It is not a personal flotation device, but the boys have tried that too. It is older than the radio, the automobile, the talking movie, the airplane, and everyone who is alive today. Now that glory is shared across continents. In 1995, the National Hockey League began to allow each winning coach and player the gift of bringing home the cup for a day, wherever home may be.
We're really the first team that actually took the cup. And let me tell you, that thing is a magnet because anybody and everybody wants a picture with it. They want to be around it. They want to touch it.
We took it to a few different places. The next day or 2 days later, it was on the front page of the Edmonton Sun. And Slats called us in and said, guys, when I told you to take the cup out and enjoy it with the fans, I didn't want you to take it to a adult entertainment place, which we put it right on the stage.
We had one rule: never embarrass the organization. That was the only rule we ever had. And we created a job for a gentleman to be with the cup full time so he could thank the Edmonton Oilers.